Well, I think it's important to understand that, that what we're going through is an actual transition, not just capital power, but the energy industry in total. And we are actually an active part of that transition.
Changing for climate.
Edmonton's energy transition goal is to reach carbon neutrality by 2050. Zero emissions electricity is essential to success. Meet Brian Vaasjo. He is the CEO of Capital Power, which produces about 20% of Alberta's electricity and the electricity we use on a daily basis. Driving electric vehicles and installing heat pumps in our homes are actions that will effectively reduce emissions, only if the power we use is emissions-free. That's where Capital Power comes in. Once owned by the City of Edmonton and formerly a major coal generator in Alberta, Capital Power has pledged to transform their electricity generation to net zero emissions by 2050.
You know, so specifically, there's that broad direction that the, eventually the energy that'll be utilized in Edmonton will be emissions-free, and we're making a significant contribution to that effort.
Today, Capital Power is also selling green energy directly to Edmonton area companies to help them reach their goals of running on 100% clean energy. As recently as 2001, Alberta had one of the most carbon-intensive grids in North America, getting 81% of its electricity from coal-fired generation. In 2022, coal will provide only 8%.
We've got a number of commitments in terms of climate change, starting with our commitment to be net zero by 2050. But we also have a target in 2030 to reduce our intensity by 65%.
Capital Power and other generators in Alberta are on track to phase out coal-fired electricity by 2023. And Alberta's coal phase-out is one of the biggest climate action success stories in Canada. These days, solar and wind power are a growing part of Capital Power's portfolio.
Our business consists of generating power from renewables, and currently, you know, we have five solar facilities, you know, in various stages of construction. We just announced another wind farm. We just completed two wind farms. So extremely active in building renewables, and we've got 11 completed plants throughout North America.
Capital Power is expanding its natural gas capacity as coal plants are converted. But renewable energy is also expected to grow significantly over time. For Capital Power, the biggest change is occurring at the massive Genesee coal-fired power plant west of Edmonton.
Genesee is a hub of activity today. We are firstly taking two of our coal facilities and repowering them at a cost of about $1 billion to extremely efficient natural gas. The third coal unit we are converting to natural gas. In addition to that, we've just announced that we're building a 210 megawatt battery on that site.
These are very efficient gas plants, but the path to net zero emissions will require much more. Energy storage will serve as a backup for a gas plant, and it can also be used to store renewable energy for later use. Genesee is also being outfitted with carbon capture and storage technology, and they are hydrogen ready, which could take Genesee to zero emissions.
The technology that we're deploying to repower Genesee has the ability to utilize hydrogen. And there is technology that'll take it to a point where it can probably be 95% or even higher utilization of hydrogen.
For Brian Vaasjo, it's great to be part of the clean energy transition.
You know, looking back, I never thought that I would be, you know, in the position I am of moving an organization like Capital Power through to a greener future. The changes that are taking place, you know, are very exciting, and they're all in the right direction.
Changing for climate.
Capital Power is part of Edmonton's Corporate Climate Leaders Program, a growing network of businesses taking steps to be more climate resilient. Learn how to become a corporate climate leader at edmonton.ca/climateleaders.